Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is the Blockchain Backer bringing you the latest cryptocurrency news and analysis. And yesterday, the Ripple XRP price chart came down and touched 23.885 cents. And as you guys know, we've been waiting so long for this to happen. I know a lot of people get, you know, real worried when they see prices falling, if they, you know, if they were buying it higher and they're seeing the prices falling. In the end, look, this is a correction. Corrections always happen. And the sooner we can get it over with, the sooner we can start moving to the upside. So for me, I'm really excited. Even if I wasn't actually doing any accumulating, what's exciting to me is we're reaching down to the targets. And right now, XRP has done more than a 50% retrace, which is the minimum requirement for me for anything. So even at this point right now, I still fully expect that we're going to pull down to here to about 22.5 cents. But even if it didn't, it has now completely, you know, hit the requirements I would have for a retracement for XRP. Now, from a structural standpoint, I don't think that's going to be the bottom. This does not look anything like what a bottom will usually look like. Usually we're going to get one more pretty sharp fall, something like that we saw right here. Probably going to get another one right over here. The second that we take out yesterday's low at 23.8, that's when I will start my accumulation on XRP. I've been very patient. I've waited 33 days to finally start being able to do it. And you know what? I'm going to tell you this. It's just because it's how I operate, right? You guys know I was very vocal, and every single time I made a buy in here preparing for this move up, I posted on Twitter with each and every one of them and made a video live, you know, not a live video, but I posted the video saying I made my buy, I made my buy, I made my buy. I haven't made a buy here yet. If something happens and I don't get an opportunity to buy, I'm okay with that. I got all my accumulating in down here. The only way I'm going to give this market my money is if it gives me Black Friday pricing, if it gives me flash sale pricing, if it gives me panic pricing. That's when I buy. I buy when things are so utterly terrifying and when the market is so mad and angry. That's when I get in. One of the main reasons that I do that is it minimizes my risk. The more scared the market is, what does that mean? It means there's more people that have already sold. And that means once this market turns back on itself, they have to FOMO back in. I would much rather have my entry be where all the people are sitting on the sideline with their money wanting to come back in than be buying after they've already put all their money in. You understand what I'm saying? If you buy when the prices are down, your odds are the prices are going to go up because the people have to FOMO back in. But if you're buying after the FOMO, well, where's the money going to come from? Where is all that fresh money going to come to pump that price up higher after you're buying after the FOMO? If you buy when it's really red and after people have already sold, the prices are tend to go up because the people have to come back in. So I like to buy when it's absolutely horrid. And I think we're almost there, which is good news, man, because that's where the bottoms are. The bottoms happen when the sellers are completely exhausted. That is how a bottom happens, when the sellers can't sell anymore and the buyers have shown up to win. We're almost there. And man, this was a big week for me with launching bcbacker.com. It was something I've been working on behind the scenes quietly, and I put my heart and my soul into this, and I consolidated really everything that I've learned over the years and put it into 4.5 hours of videos to really kind of give you an idea of how I do a lot of the charting things that I do on TradingView and on charts.cointrader.pro. So I really teach you the different, you know, indicators and the tools. And I teach, you know, about managing risk and really this really deep diving into the tools and the different indicators. But in the end, this, you're going to learn things about charting in here, right? I know people want to learn those things. So I made sure to include that in here. But I think it's really being able to use any of that type of charting stuff. You have to have a bigger understanding of where this market is and where it's going to. So in like a moment like today or a moment like yesterday, if you were emotionally feeling the pain of yesterday and not feeling the excitement of it at all, it's because there's just a mindset shift that needs to happen here. And it's becoming looking at the much bigger picture and understanding where this market has come from and where this market is going. And I really lay out all of that in this course in 4.5 hours, 19 videos. These are not like YouTube videos. These are videos that I recorded specifically for this. And I can't imagine anybody watching this thing and then like during a day like yesterday be panicking. I just couldn't imagine it because that's what I really tried to do. I tried to going through this to try to transform the way that you see this all. So there's a ton of content in here. It was exciting for me to release it, and I hope that you check it out. So once again, bcbacker.com. Not a whole lot to say on the charts except for the fact that it was complete craziness yesterday and that we're still waiting for that next move. And really, it looks like it could come at any time. So keep an eye on my Twitter page at bcbacker because like I like to do, I don't ever want to be the guy who comes in and says, hey, I bought yesterday when the price was really low. Now that the price is way up, hey, I wanted you to know I bought yesterday before it did that. Nope, that's not how I do it. If the thing's crashing, I will post the moment that I'm buying it. And you know what? If it keeps crashing, well, then you got to see it. You got to see the blockchain backer get wrecked. But I have conviction in what I do, and that's why I will post it live when it does happen, because I don't ever want to be the guy who comes out and says, hey, this is what I did yesterday. I always want to be the guy of, you have the evidence of me showing you exactly when I did it. And you know what? You can't be right 100% of the time, but I always want you to know exactly when I'm doing things. So keep an eye on my Twitter page because I'm getting a feeling that moment could be coming today or tomorrow. So a lot of the coins that we saw getting really hit hard yesterday, I saw Zcash at negative 25%. It was just like, wow. There was a lot of coins getting wrecked, especially the coins that have really already super pumped, right? And got really FOMO'd in. Those ones have really taken a hit. And in general, XRP has not really taken as bad of a hit as the rest of the market has. So not too bad to be an XRP holder. But if there's anything else out there that you're wanting to buy, we're starting to see some serious interesting pricing. And I have a feeling that when Bitcoin makes one more dip, so, you know, Bitcoin hit $10,000 yesterday. We get that dip down to 9,700, 9,500, 9,200, whatever it is, somewhere in those mid 9,000s. It's probably a good opportunity to be accumulating whatever it is you're wanting to put in your bag. But it is an exciting time. I mean, it really is. And, you know, you just have to see it from the right angle, man. If you understand that corrections have to happen and we're almost at the end of the correction, it means that the upward trajectory starts very soon. So keep an eye on my Twitter, at bcbacker. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I know this is a little bit of a shorter video. There's not a whole lot to say. We've just had crazy price action. But the thing is, we've talked about it for so long. It's not that there's a whole lot to say. It's not like we come on here and say, oh my gosh, what is happening? Let's go find the news story that could cause all of this. Nope, we were prepared. We expected it. So we're just about there. And hopefully it finishes itself off today. So I'm ready for it. Keep an eye on my Twitter at bcbacker. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching my channel. Please like this video and give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. Hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you can be notified of when I create new content and when I go live. As always, this is not investment advice and I am not a financial advisor. But if you ever need a pick-me-up or a little bit of reassurance, just remember that the blockchain backers got your back. Have a good one.